Welcome to Springs Kids. I'm Miranda.
And I'm Joni. We're so glad you're joining us today.
If you are 4 or 5 years old, this is for you.
We'd love to have you check out one of our Kinderchurch classes in Winnipeg or Calgary.
You'll have so much fun playing games,
doing praise and worship,
and learning a brand new lesson from the Bible every week.
Each week, we talk about something really important to us.
Laugh. We spell it a bit differently. Here, we spell it L-A-F, because each letter stands for something really important to us.
L stands for love. We want to make sure we love others the same way that Jesus loves us.
Showing love is not just saying, I love you. Love is an action and something you do by listening to people,
spending time with them,
helping them with chores,
or even giving them a hug or a high five.
A stands for accept. God made everyone unique and special, and we want to accept everyone the way they are.
The last letter is F, and it stands for forgive. Everyone makes mistakes, and it's important that when we make mistakes, we're quick to forgive, because we love one another.
We've got an awesome lesson prepared for you this week. Let's all stand up so we can start with praise and worship.
Can do anything. Wow, oh wow, shout wow. Jesus can do anything. Jesus is amazing. He's incredible. There's no one like him. Jesus does miracles, the impossible. There's no one like him. He's big and strong. So I clap.
Everyone, this month we're learning that God can help us be brave. The Bible verse we'll begin learning today will help us remember that we can always be brave. It says, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, for the Lord your God goes with you." Deuteronomy 31:6. Our memory verse teaches us that we never have to be afraid because God goes with us. And God can help us be brave. Let's stand up and say that verse with the motions. Just say what I say and do what I do. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, for the Lord your God goes with you. Deuteronomy 31:6. Yay! I love learning more about what the Bible has to teach us. I can't wait to hear about what else we'll learn about in today's lesson. I think our clubhouse friends are ready. Let's watch.
Who? Who? Know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down to the clubhouse where wonder never ends at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Me and you
at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Me and you.
Hey, friends. It's your friend Hayden. Does this look like a shield to you? It may not look like one now, but it's about to. See, my brother has a cool shield. It's big, it's heavy, and it's so cool. And I'm gonna make my own shield using these supplies. Ready, set, shield! Wait a minute. This doesn't feel anything like my brother's shield. This feels like not a shield.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Hayden. Who? Who? Is something bothering you?
Yes, Ollie. I'm a little sad that my shield I made doesn't look or feel anything like my brother's shield.
Shields are cool. Yes, it's true. I know a boy who was brave without one. Who? Who? Listen up. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through. Who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Wow, Stormy, you are so brave. You walked past all those big dogs and didn't bark. Great job, Stormy. Here's your treat. Oh, hi, friends. I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog, Stormy Jane. She was just so brave on our walk today. Hey, you know what? That reminds me of a story. Do you want to hear it? Well, Stormy does. Today's true story from the Bible starts with a boy named David. David was a shepherd, which means he took care of sheep. David had to be very brave to protect his sheep both day and night. David knew that he could be strong and courageous while he took care of his sheep because God was always with him. Well, one day, David went to visit his brothers who were in God's army. And while he was with them, David heard this really big, really scary giant named Goliath saying mean things to God's army, the Israelites. Goliath teased the Israelites.
Nah. Who's gonna challenge me?
Well, the Israelites were so afraid. Show me your afraid face. Yes, all of the Israelites were so afraid. But wait, didn't we just talk about someone who was strong and courageous because he knew that God is always with him? What was his name? Yell it out on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. Yes, David. Do you think David is going to be brave enough to challenge the giant? Well, Goliath came out and teased the Israelites again. He said,
Who's gonna challenge me?
And David said, I'll do it. Everyone was so surprised. David was not a soldier. How could he challenge the giant? But David knew something important. David knew that he could be strong and courageous because God was always with him. They put armor on David, but it didn't fit, and it was too big and heavy for him. David said he didn't need the armor. He knew God was with him, and that made David brave. Then, David took a slingshot and 5 smooth rocks and went to challenge the giant. Goliath said, "Who's gonna challenge me?" "Me," said David bravely. Goliath said,
You're just a kid.
So David took out his slingshot and said, "Goliath, you may have all your big weapons, but God is with me." Then he put 1 rock in the slingshot and slung it right at Goliath. The rock hit Goliath and knocked him all the way down. God's army was so excited. David had saved them from the mean giant. Let's celebrate too. Hooray! I knew David could do it because he knew God was with him. God helped David be brave both in the field with his sheep and on the battlefield with Goliath. And God can help you be brave too. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who can help you be brave?
God can help me be brave. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who can help you be brave?
God can help me be brave. That's the truth, friends. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story, and it's all true. God helped David be brave, and God can help you be brave too.
Thanks, Ali.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, God was with David, and that made David super brave. And he didn't even have a shield. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it? Good. You know, I don't need a big heavy shield to be brave. And I'm going to write God is with me on this shield so I can remember I can always be brave. See you next time. Bye.
Guys, I'm so glad you joined us here today. We love learning about God, how much He loves us, and the amazing things He wants us to do. Did you know that you are loved so much by God that He sent His Son Jesus to die on a cross? He died, but He is such a hero. The best and true hero that He defeated death, came back to life, and wants to be our best friend forever. How amazing is that? You know what? We're going to pray a super awesome prayer right now where we can ask Him to come into our hearts, be with us forever, and help us be superheroes too. With God in our hearts, we can live the best life possible. We can be brave, we can be strong, we can have joy and peace. He gives us healing when we're sick, is a friend when we're lonely, and gives us blessings so amazing we can't even imagine. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for dying on a cross for me and coming back to live to be my forever friend. I want to live for you, follow you, and love you forever and ever. Please come into my heart, help me to learn and grow every single day, and be more like you. Amen. Wow, I'm so glad you prayed that prayer with me. If you don't have a Bible at home, you can ask your parents to contact us, and we'll send you one. And don't forget to tell them to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss a thing. Have an awesome week. See you next time.